This is where I lived in Portland for a time. This spring, the air was crisp and fresh, and it seemed as though anything were possible. It was a special time of year because of the light in the leaves, and the light in the sky, and the light in her eyes, which seemed as though it had been lodged there by the very sun itself as it sank below the horizon. As my heart beat in my chest like the wings of a heron, the migration across the space between us, emotion, the morning could know what would resolve itself out of the stillness, the quiet between us, or where any of these journeys would end. We knew was motion and movement, and time passing like the oily slippers of a gentleman walking to his pipe closet each evening, as our brains scattered mental graffiti across the landscapes of our thoughts and our bodies. We could only look outward, away, some future running ahead and behind of us like train tracks into the distance. Across the city, stilettoed with buildings and heartbreaks and memories that would never quiet themselves long enough to give a straight answer about anything. I lived for a time in the woods, in the swamplands, because I had nowhere else to go. It seemed like only the reeds rustling in the wind spoke a language that I could understand. Only the cloudy iris of the sun sinking to the night's horizon truly looked out with any measure of grace and beauty upon the land. It was a long night. It was a long day, or so it seemed, one of many, or just one long day. The sun always hovering inches above the horizon, refusing to the penultimate step into darkness. But even these eyes of the day must eventually close for the night.